This is me, Aisha Malwankar, and I'm here to welcome you all on behalf of Auxilium Convent High School, Bandra. Firstly, I would like to thank you all for being here on this beautiful annual day, come the Diamond Jubilee of our school. Yes, you heard me right. This year, our school, Auxilium Convent High School, Bandra, celebrates 60 years of providing good education to students like us. So without any further delay, let us now begin with the program. But wait, I think I'm forgetting something. What is it? Ah, your mobile phones. Come on, take them out. Come on, take them out. And click my picture. Look how beautiful I'm looking today. Thank you. Now, I want you all to keep your mobile phones on silent. Ta-ding. So are you all ready to watch the superstar performances by our Auxilium stars?
Yes.
Sorry, I can't hear.
Yes.
So ladies and gentlemen, please take an attitude of prayer as the students of Standard 2nd come up with the prayer dance.
Thank you.
respected manager, principal, honored guests, beloved teachers, sisters, fathers, proud parents, generous benefactors, well-wishers, and my dear fellow friends.
A very warm welcome to each and every one of you to this momentous occasion. As we gather here to celebrate not only the annual day of our school, but also its magnificent milestone of its time in Jubilee. It's a privilege to stand before you as a student representative filled with a sense of pride and joy. 60 years of academic excellence, 60 years of shaping minds and molding characters, 60 years of dream realized and future forged. This is the legacy we celebrate today. Our school has been a crucible of learning, a sanctuary of growth, and a beacon of hope for generations. It has stood the test of time, nurturing young minds and preparing them to face the world with confidence and wisdom. A special word of welcome to esteemed chief guest, Father Joby Matthew, SSP, whose presence here today is an immense honor for us. Your guidance and wisdom are invaluable, and we are truly privileged to have you here with us. We also extend a heartfelt welcome to our guest of honor, the parents of Miss Almira and Miss Caroline, the top scorers of SSC March 2023. Your unwavering support and guidance have played an important role in the success of these remarkable students. Today, we not only celebrate their achievements, but also your dedication as parents. To the parents and sisters, benefactors and friends, we extend our warmest welcome. Your presence here today is a testimony to the strength of our community and the bonds that tie us together.
As we revel in the festivities and reflect upon this incredible journey, let us take a moment to acknowledge the dedication and vision of our founders, the tireless efforts of our teachers, and the unwavering support of our parents. Together, they have laid the foundation upon which we stand, and for that, we are profoundly grateful. Today, we stand on the verge of a new era where we, the students, inherit the legacy that has been entrusted to us. It is a responsibility we do not take lightly. We are the torch bearers of the next 60 years. And it is our duty to carry forward the values, traditions, and excellence that define our beloved school. As we celebrate this momentous Diamond Jubilee, let us also look ahead with hope and anticipation. Let us strive for even greater heights, knowing that with determination and unity, we can overcome any challenges that comes our way. To our teachers, thank you for your tireless efforts, your unwavering belief in us, and your commitment to our growth. To our parents, thank you for your endless support, your sacrifices, and your belief in the power of education. And to my fellow friends, let us cherish this moment. Let us celebrate the legacy that we are a part of. And let us embark on this new chapter with enthusiasm and purpose. Once again, a warm welcome to all. Let the celebration begin. Thank you.
Our chief guest, Father Jobby Matthew, our guest of honor, our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, our principal, Sister Shiny Alphonse, to kindly proceed to the dais. We also invite the guest of honor, the parents of Miss Almira and Miss Caroline.
Good evening, everybody. I am honored to have the privilege of introducing our esteemed chief guest, Reverend Father Jobby Matthew, SSP. Born on October 14, 1976, in Pious Mount, Kerala, Father Jobby Matthew's journey has been marked with unwavering dedication and remarkable achievements. Father Jobby Matthew embarked on his spiritual path when he entered the congregation on July 10, 1991. On January 28, 2006, he was ordained as a priest, an important moment in his journey of service and faith. Post-ordination, Father Jobby Matthew assumed the directorship of the Teenager magazine, a role he held until 2011. His commitment to nurturing young minds and spirits was evident in his stewardship of this publication. He pursued a master's in science and publishing, completing his studies in 2015. Returning to Mumbai, he was entrusted with the important role of directing the publications of the province. In 2018, he transitioned to the sphere of marketing and took on the additional responsibilities of advertising and sales for both St. Paul's and Better Yourself books. Father Jobby Matthew's contributions extend beyond the confines of his publications. Since 2019, Father Jobby Matthew has been a dedicated collaborator with the Archdiocese of Bombay, serving as the secretary of the Conference of Religious India, a member of the Council of Priests, and a key figure in the Committee of Managing Natural Calamities. Currently, Father Jobby Matthew is the Provincial Superior of the Society of St. Paul, a testament to his leadership and trust placed in him by his peers and superiors alike. We look forward to the invaluable insights and inspiration Father Jobby Matthew will bring to us on our annual day and Diamond Jubilee celebration. We are honored to have him grace this special occasion.
Now, I request our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, to felicitate our chief guest with a bouquet and a token of love and gratitude. Let us give a huge round of applause. Thank you. reach high, for stars lie hidden in your soul. Dream deep, for every dream leads the goal. We are honored and delighted to have our SSC toppers and their parents with us this evening. As we recognize and applaud the outstanding achievements of two remarkable young ladies, Miss Caroline and Miss Elmira, our SSC toppers for the year 2022-23. They have not only excelled academically, but also exhibited exceptional qualities that make us proud to call them our students. Their success is not just a reflection of their personal brilliance, but also a testament to the guidance and support they have received from their loving parents. We extend a warm welcome to you and to your parents, Mr. and Mrs. Alan Cardos, and Mr. and Mrs. Rizwan Ahmed. Dear girls, you have kept the banner of Auxilium flying high, and we are proud of you. Now, I request our headmistress, Sister Shiny Alphonse, to felicitate them with potted plants and a token of love and appreciation. Dear parents, let us put our hands together and welcome them. Parents, continue clapping. Today, we are privileged to have with us Mrs. Sarita Patil, the District Commissioner of Guides, West Mumbai. We extend a warm welcome to you, ma'am, with a potted plant. Your parents continue clapping. We also welcome Father Jude Fernandez, Manager of St. Xavier's College, Dobitalao. We also extend our warmest welcome to Sister Shanti Fernandez of Auxilium Convent School, Wadala. We welcome you, Sister. We are happy to have with us our dear Sister Salome D'Souza, Superior of Auxilium Center, Bandra, and her sisters. We welcome you, Sister. We also extend a warm welcome to Father Francis from St. Paul's. Dear parents, put your hands together and give a huge round of applause. We also extend a hearty welcome to all the principals of different congregations. Sister Gloria Farrow, the principal of Auxilium Convent School, Wadala. Sister Maria Pegado, the principal of St. Joseph's School, Bandra. Sister Mary Virginia, the principal of Durello Convent School, Bandra. Sister Zarina, the principal of St. Joseph's, Malad. Miss Natty Narona, Headmistress of St. Anne's School, Primary School, Bandra. We are very happy to have you with us today. We extend a hearty welcome to you. We also extend a hearty welcome to all the sisters, fathers who are present for this function. And you, dear parents, who are an integral part of our Auxilium family, welcome one and all. Without further ado, I would like to invite our chief guest, Reverend Father Jovi Matthew, to address the gathering with your insights, wisdom, and words of inspiration with us all.
Standing at St. Andrew's Auditorium gives me nostalgic feeling, because about 25 years ago, I was a student of St. Andrew's College and had many opportunities to be here in this auditorium. And it gives a very warm and special feeling to stand here and look at all of you eagerly awaiting spectacular performances from your beloved children. At the same time, when I think of the significance of this day, when the school celebrates their Diamond Jubilee, 60 years of dedication and commitment to quality education, and celebration of the achievement of this year, the annual day. Respected guests on the dais, special invitees, parents, teachers, sisters, fathers, and my dear students. When we celebrate annual day of a school, we celebrate the dedication. We celebrate the commitment. And we have heard many messages. I'm sure the parents of students of the high school class 7, 8, or 9, 10 have heard at least for the last 8 years messages on the annual day. What I want to share with you today is one simple thought. All of our celebration, all of the achievements of Auxilium High School Bandra for the last 60 years boil down, according to me, to one message: that never take your life for granted. If the school was able to achieve what it has achieved today, 60 years of influencing young lives and continually being able to give quality education, it's because they have taken every moment of their lives, and every child, no matter what intellectual capacity that child has, they took every child seriously. And that is seen in the results that the school brings out year after year. Never take your life for granted. Consider every moment as a gift. Or else we might end up with the 10th apple effect. I don't know if you have heard this story of the 10th apple effect. A hunter lost his way in the deep forest, and as he went searching for a way out, he ran out of food, water, and even after a week, of search, he could not get out of the forest. Desperate, hopeless situation. And then, out of good luck, he spots an apple tree in the forest. He was very happy, and he collects as much as he thought he would need to continue his search and to come out of the forest. And of course, he was very hungry, and he began to eat one apple. And then he had the second apple, the third, the fourth, the fifth. And as you would also know, that as he went on eating one after the other, his interest, his taste began to diminish. And by the time he reached the 10th apple, he was not interested at all. He thought, oh, it's no taste, because by now his hunger had already diminished. But what he didn't realize was the apple that he received, or the apple tree that he found, or the apples that he collected, didn't change any taste. The apples were so good. The 10th apple was as good as the first apple, but his gratitude diminished. His gratitude for finding those apples diminished as his hunger diminished. This is what sometimes happens in our life too, my dear parents, my dear students. As we gain more and more knowledge, as we gain more and as we grow technologically, we forget our past. But if we can remember our past, and if we can take every moment seriously, then we will begin to nurture and we will begin to appreciate what we receive, not just from our school, but from our parents, from our society, and we will begin to give. We'll begin to give back to the society, to the family, and to those around us. And this is what I want to wish you today. Take your life seriously. The apple, the taste of the apple didn't change, but the attitude of the hunter made it bad. Excuse me. It is our attitude towards events of our life, it's our attitude towards what happens around us that determines how we make the best of those events or those persons. Today we celebrate 60 years of the school, the management, and the teachers, the non-teaching staff of Auxilium High School, taking life seriously, taking each one of you seriously. Each one of you who have passed out of this school seriously, and we celebrate the dedication and we celebrate your success. The programs that you will witness a while from now again show forth the commitment. Every student taking her life seriously, giving 100% to this program, and that's what we are going to enjoy. And let this be our attitude too. No matter where we are, no matter what we do, let us think and take our life seriously. I wish to congratulate the management for successfully completing 60 years of sharing of knowledge. May God bless you that you continue this noble profession, noble mission of touching the lives of young girls and making them responsible citizens of our nation or responsible citizens of the earth, because today we can never predict where these students will reach. Could be in India or any part of the world, but your contribution will definitely be remembered. I also want to wish and congratulate the top scorers of the last academic year and their parents for taking your life seriously and continuing to work hard. You will be an example not just for your fellow students in the school, but for all of us. And do not give up. Continue to work with the same determination, and success and success will be yours. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you, Father Joby, for sharing such insightful and inspiring words with us today. Your words have added immense value to this event, and we are truly privileged to have received your wisdom and insights. Thank you, Father. Our esteemed chief guests and dignitaries will proceed to their seats.
Good evening, everybody. It is Tasmiya Sheikh to speak up about the 60 years of successful journey. Tasmiya, is that you? You're from Auxilium. Show some spark in yourself. Hello, everyone. It is Tasmiya Sheikh to speak up about the 60 years of successful journey of Auxilium Convent High School. Amazing, right? Yes. An interesting novel of my school. And I know that you all are going to get surprised when I will execute a marvelous, wonderful, and enthusiastic story of my school. And I hope the mobile phones will not be a source of distraction for this grand event. So, let's sit and watch the 60 years of successful journey of my school. Of course, Auxilium Convent Bandra. And give a big round of applause for our superstar performance. So, here we go. 60 years of Auxilium.
chitra ke maskar.
Ekko kitna patches patches modas kya bolera.
Switch shots it made me shitty. I can endure a speed I'm nifty. I hope I live till I'm 50. See my city girl quit to the 50.
I'm moving on your own shoes.
appreciate our management, who have been guarding our souls with their timely support and profound love, and also their ritualistic guidance at all times, their logical thinking and interdisciplinary approach has made our school a more fortified fort with the walls of great values, mental ability and conducive learning environment.
के जूता कस के बेल्ट खोस के अंदर अपनी शर्ट मंजिल को चली सवारी कंधों पे जिम्मेदारी हाथ में फाइल मन में दम मीलों मील चलेंगे हम हर मुश्किल से टकराएंगे टस से मस ना होंगे हम
दुनिया का नारा जमे रहो मंजिल का इशारा जमे रहो
ये सोते भी है टेंशन आगे रहने की है टेंशन मेहनत इनको प्यारी है एकदम आज्ञाकारी है आज्ञाकारी है ये ऑमलेट पर ही जीते हैं ये टॉनिक सारे पीते हैं वक्त पे सोते वक्त पे खाते तान के सीना बढ़ते जाते
कोई सांस है हर काम को टाला करते हैं ये सपने पाला करते हैं पाने की हो आस आस कोई अरमा हो जो खास खास आशाएं हर कोशिश में हो बार बार कर दरियाओं को आर बार आशाएं तूफानों को छीन के मंजिलों को छीन ले आशाएं
has also lent its empathetic hands to the development of the special section of our society, the less financially sound and the more able in different aspects, who just needed a small spark to ignite their souls. We have been fortunate to reinforce their self-belief and empower them with education to further provide vision and feel more desirable. Apart from this, the management also believe in developing a strong, sustainable environment where ideas are breeded and efforts are appreciated.
Ladies and gentlemen, please clap for these small kids. Those who are doing blindfold, they cannot see on stage. They are like our pure student, and the behind, like the teachers who always support their future. And some.
Pighla de zanjeere bana unki shamshire kar har maidan fateh o bandiya kar har है तू दिखला दे जिंदा है तू काफी है तुझ में हौसला तेरी जुनू की आगे अंबर पनाही मांगे कर डाल तू जो फैसला
warm evening to our respected chief guest, Father Joby Matthew, our superior, Sister Teresa Platra, our headmistress, Sister Shiny Alphonse, Reverend Fathers, Sisters, all our honored guests, and our dear parents.
On behalf of the editorial team, I am given the privilege to speak a few words. Our school magazine, Precious Gems, will be released shortly on the occasion of Diamond Jubilee of our school. This magazine is the face of the school, and it displays the personality of the school in many ways. It informs the future generation of students about the traditions built up in our school. Our young talented writers have found their first exposure through this specific medium. This valuable publication is the opportunity that students require to showcase their creative talents. I thank our management for their support, our students for their creative talent, our sponsors, our parents for encouraging their children in sharing their thoughts, and my entire editorial team for their tedious work throughout the process. Thank you once again. We welcome on stage Reverend Father Joby Matthew, our superior Sister Teresa Plathra, and our headmistress, Sister Shiny Alphonse, to release the Diamond Jubilee Precious Gems magazine.
We would also like to honor our well-wishers for their constant support towards the success of this event. I call upon Mr. Vijay Chaurarya, Advocate Mr. Ashish Shelar, our MLA, Tech Mahindra Pali Hill, Bandra, Mr. Yash, Director, CBM, Ms. Sunita D'Souza, our ex-student, Mr. and Mrs. Murtaza Golawala, proprietor, Good Luck Stores, please do come ahead. Rizwan Patka, Director, Ashiana Villa Resorts. Mr. Betsal, Navneet Publications. Thank you. Mr. Jayesh, Variety Emporium. Mr. Asif Bamla, founder of Bamla Foundation. Mr. Sunil Solanki, decorator for the event. Mr. Wilfred Fernandez, parishioner from St. Anne's Church. Ms. Shabana, our ex-student. Mrs. Dipali Darshan Bose, our parent. Patrikar, our parent. Imran Pawar, our parent. Individuals who have gone above and beyond to ensure the safety of our children. It's with great pride that we present a well-deserved trophy to Mr. Nitin Pawar and Mrs. Niyati Pawar, our dedicated parent representatives, for their outstanding commitment for managing traffic, selflessness and dedication, ensuring the smooth flow of traffic during drop-off, pick-up, rain or shine. This trophy symbolizes our deep appreciation for their invaluable service and their dedication to our children's safety. Incredible talent and dedication of a remarkable choreographer, Mr. Saiba Sayed, and his team, for their outstanding work in training our schoolgirls and choreographing a mesmerizing dance for our Diamond Jubilee celebration. And his talented team.
stage.
Thank you, Reverend Father Jovi, our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, and our headmistress, Sister Shiny Alphonse, for doing their honors.
Here we have Saiba and his team.
Auxilium Convent High School scholarships awarded for the year 2022-23. Standard 4, General Proficiency, Harshika Kotekar. Mr. M.S. Sharma Memorial Scholarship for the student of Standard 4 who secured the highest percentage in English, Harshika Kotekar. Abdullah Khan Scholarship okay. I request our chief guest Father Jovi to give away the awards. Mr. Late Mukarrab Abdullah Khan Scholarship for an all-round student from primary section, Zaira Mullah. Mr. M.S. Sharma Memorial Scholarship for the student of Standard 4 who secured the highest percentage in English, Laiba Sheikh. Gratian and Myra Pace Scholarship for the most needy and deserving students, Bhavi Goyal. Standard 5, General Proficiency, Sadaf Khan. Mr. M.S. Sharma Memorial Scholarship for the student of Standard 5 who secured the highest percentage in English, Asta Visaria. The Gillian Murziello Scholarship for the most happiest, most friendly student of Standard 5, Abira Sheikh. Ms. Myrtle Fonseca Memorial Scholarship for an all-round Catholic student of Standard 5, Angel Fernandez. Thank you, Father, for giving away the scholarships. Now I invite our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, to give away the scholarships. Standard 6, General Proficiency, Rizquin Bakhari. Ramesh Sharma Memorial Scholarship for the student of Standard 6 who secured the highest percentage in English, Danshika Wate. Kala Karnik Scholarship for the most deserving student of Standard 6, Janvi Mandal. Standard 7, General Proficiency, Huzaifa Khan. Mr. M.S. Sharma Memorial Scholarship for the student of Standard 7 who secured the highest percentage in English, Safa Khan. Ruth Ann Evelyn Alvarez Scholarship for the most deserving student of Standard 7, Anushka Sarkar. Late Mr. Sharad Jada Scholarship for the most friendliest student of Standard 7, Riddhi Jha. Standard 8, General Proficiency, Devyani Jha. Aishwarya Dandekar Memorial Scholarship by Management, Staff and Students of Standard 8, Batch 2010 for the best outgoing student of Standard 8, Nicolette Fernandez. Mamta Vaghela Memorial Scholarship to the student who secures the highest percentage in Standard 8, Palak Rajpurohit. Miss Olga Fonseca Memorial Scholarship for a deserving Christian student of Standard 8, Brianna Rosario. Thank you, Sister Superior, for giving away the scholarship. Now I call upon our principal, Sister Shiny Alphonse, to give away the scholarships. Standard 9th, General Proficiency, Prachi Lange. Miss Lily Fonseca Memorial Scholarship for an all-round Catholic student of Standard 9, Zenobia De Cruz. The Eva De Silva Scholarship for the most deserving student of Standard 9, Rudra Raghuvanshi. Standard 10th, Mrs. Angela Farrow Scholarship to a student of Standard 10 who secures the highest percentage in the SSC board exam. Now, two of them have got Almira Ahmed and Caroline Carlos. Thank you. parents, please give them a round of applause. Oswald Carvalho Scholarship for the student who secured the highest percentage in English in the SSC board exam, Caroline Cardos. Dr. Satendranath Ramchandra Thadkar Memorial Scholarship for the SSC student who secures the highest percentage in Marathi, Jalak Rajpurohit. Dr. Satendranath Ramchandra Thadkar Memorial Scholarship for the SSC student who secures the highest percentage in Hindi, Jalak Rajpurohit. Ashwini Nagda Scholarship for the most regular student of Standard 10, Jalak Rajpurohit. She deserves. Miss L.C. De Silva Scholarship for an all-round student of Standard 10th, Nicole Rosario. The Eva Fernandez Memorial Scholarship for an hard-working student of Standard 10, Aisha Khan. Mr. Michael Correa Scholarship for the most enthusiastic student in science of Standard 10. There are two girls, Rashmi Nirmal, Sneha Singh. Ashwini Nagda Scholarship for the most regular student of Standard 10, Kavita Chimbaikar, Tasmiya Khan, and Rushti Kopte. Madhumati Loth Scholarship for deserving students in any class between 5th to Standard 10th, Masira Khan, Stuti Jadhav, Suhana Qureshi, Avni Gade. Mrs. Shobha Chauraria Scholarship for the most deserving students, Rachita Kokte, Shreya Satyasilam, Arya Shelar, Shikha Singh, Mr. Gresham and Myra Pace Scholarship for the most needy and deserving students, Standard 5, Pranjal Gaikwad. Standard 6, Tanzia Sayed. Standard 7, Zuleika Sheikh. Standard 8, Saleha Sheikh. Mr. M.G. Phillips Scholarship for the most deserving student in the secondary section, Anishka Shinde. Thank you, sister. Now I call upon our chief guest, Father Jovi, to give away the scholarships. The Annabelle De Silva Scholarship for the Best in Dramatics in the secondary section, Tasmia Sheikh. Mrs. Anna Maria Scholarship to the most committed leader of the year, Akansha Sonavne. Please clap. Mrs. Anna Maria Scholarship to the most regular teacher of the year, Mrs. Philomena Dias. Ashwini Navda Scholarship for the most hard-working non-teaching staff, Mr. Lawrence DeCosta. Clap hands, parents. Master Bhushan Savant Scholarship for the support staff, Mr. Felix D'Souza. Invite our superior, our principal, to give away the trophies to the SSC toppers. SSC toppers for the year 2022-23. First place, two girls, Caroline Cardos, Almira Ahmed, securing 90%. Thank you. second place, Jalak Rajpurohit. She gets 89.60. Third place, Sneha Singh, 88.20. Thank you, Father, for releasing the magazine and for giving away the scholarship. Thank you, Sister Teresa Plattro. Thank you, our principal, Sister Shaini.
God created the world in 7 days, the land and foliage and the water waves. He within placed all the animals and all the creatures. He made fishes in the sea and placed them all there. And then he made humans, Adam and Eve, in paradise. God gave them this beautiful earth and one advice. You may eat of all of that on earth abounds, except for the fruit of the forbidden tree around. God was pleased with all his work and rested on the 7th day. Since then, indeed, human has come long, long way.
Adam and Eve, they did disobey and ate of the forbidden fruit. God, they did betray. Through the sin of Adam and Eve, mankind lost the Garden of Eden at a tremendous cost. And God demanded them to leave. Mankind was given the earth, starting with Adam and Eve. Since that day, men took over the earth and began to toil, cultivating the earth and planting in fertile soil. Humans began to evolve. We began to create and invent. We began mistreating our Mother Earth. Oh, what a terrible state. Look at what happened when man disobeyed God. Adam and Eve bringing on suffering with their own accord. Listen to our dear Mother Earth. As she cries, she wails today. She's crying for help. Let's listen if we may.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And the earth was formless and empty, and waters and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening and there was morning the first day. The second day, God said, "Put an expanse between the waters on the earth and the waters above." And God called the expanse sky. On the third day, God said, "Let dry ground appear and separate the waters on the earth." And it was so. God called the dry ground land, and waters he called seas. And God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let the land produce vegetation, plants and trees." The land produced plants and trees bearing fruit according to their kinds. And God saw that it was good. The fourth day, God said, "Let there be lights in the expanse of the sky to give light on earth." And it was so. God made two great lights, the sun to govern the day and the moon to govern the night. He also made the stars and set them in the expanse of the sky. And God saw that it was good. On the fifth day, God said, "Let the waters be filled with living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the sky." So God created the great creatures of the sea, and every winged bird according to its kind. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, "Let the land produce living creatures according to their kinds, livestock, creatures that move along the ground, and wild animals, each according to its kind." And it was so. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth." So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God saw all that he had made, and it was very good. And there was evening and there was morning the sixth day. By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested.
morning, and the sun smiles with its warmth. The birds spread their wings as they soar the vast blue sky. The flowers give off their scents, fragrance fills.
Thank you.
Wow, my fishes seem to be replaced by your trash. You were meant to stay together, not rule each other. Why is it so difficult for you to live without plastic than to live without water? Seeing this makes me feel miserable. Will the future generation admire the beauty of the sea, or just an image of what used to be? Spilling of chemicals, release of poisonous gases, production of plastic. Can you stop tormenting me?
Saving the earth in her hour of need.
I've come to rack and ruin your help I need. I protected you all with my mantle, my atmosphere. Hush! Look around, and what do you see and hear? You have ruined every part of me, my heart, my soul. You have torn me to shreds. The Creator made us whole.
We are paying price by way of hurricanes, floods, and tsunamis. We are paying dearly with every drop of blood.
You chose sufficiency over efficiency, greed over need, profit over people, corruption over consumption. How can you succeed? You curbed generation. You fell down my forest trees. You pollute my land, my air, my seas. You have ruined what God made as a gift to men. You do everything to ruin and spoil what you can. It's hurting my very heart, my soul, my core. Mortal men, will you stop felling down trees by the score? It depletes the oxygen we all need to breathe and live. Why don't you learn to be gentle and learn to give?
मुझसे है सांसों की तुझ में रवानी, मैं ना रहा तो रहेगा न पानी. मुझसे है सांसों की तुझ में रवानी, मैं ना रहा तो रहेगा न पानी.
Thank you.
को फल फूल छाया, तू तो समझ ही न पाया। था मैं हरा फिर भी काटा गया, तुझको नजर भी न आया। मैंने दिया तुमको फल फूल छाया, तू तो समझ ही न पाया। था मैं हरा फिर भी काटा गया, तुझको नजर भी न आया।
Mars the Earth, his inventions and creations are giving birth to disaster. The ozone layer is depleted and it's not in a good state. We must save the blanket or atmosphere before it's too late.
Thank you.
In every way and in every sphere, human does choose to harm, ruin and to damage. God's glory is dying a painful death through creation. Everywhere, every corner of the world and every nation.
Love it.
today we come to you humbly, O dear Mother Earth. We are going to give it our very best for all we are worth. First, we turn back and look at our Creator and proclaim together that we make a promise to keep to His name.
Creator and God of this universe, wonderful and great, free us from this sorry and dreadful state. Take us out of this fire that we made with our own hands. We have polluted the water, soil and air.
We promise to care for your creation. From this day, we will nurture our earth and look after it in every way. We honor you, we worship you. We promise to care for the things of Mother Earth by just being aware.
We come back to earth, our hearts filled with joy. Yes, every girl and every boy. It depends on a young shoulder to make us beautiful and prove it what God meant it to be, pure heaven.
Let us be accountable, our hearts, minds and souls. Let us help to heal our Mother Earth. That's the least we can do for God, who gave us this beautiful universe, so diverse and so fresh. Let us do what we can in the place where we stand and bring glory to God. Yes, mortal man, everything's going to be all right.
Audience, kindly note that there will be many more performances and surprises after the vote of thanks. So kind request to be seated till the end of the program. Respected manager, Sister Teresa Platila, Principal Sister Shiny Alphonse, our chief guest, Father Joby Matthew, guests, teachers, parents, and my dear friends, a very good evening to one and all. At the closing of this momentous day, I stand before you with a heart filled with gratitude and a sense of pride, for this day was not just about festivities.
Get ready for a captivating dance journey through Maharashtra, Gujarat, Goa and Punjab. From Marathi to Garba, Fugri and Bhangra, these dances will showcase the rich traditions of these four Indian states. So enjoy the performance.
Thank you. गले गले हो गए तेरी बल्ले बल्ले हो जाएगी बल्ले बल्ले
It's something great. Yes. Our teachers are going to perform the last event for you all. And it's the this performance comes as a sign of gratitude to our loving principal, Sister Shaini Alphonse, for her tireless and encouraging support what she has given us for the past 8 years. So sit back, enjoy yourself at the lovely ladies coming next.
शीश झुकावा मेरी दिल जानिया तेरे नाम जो कर जावा कम है तू सारे जहां से प्यारी मेरे भारत की बेटी सारे जहां पे भारी मेरे भारत की बेटी दिल जान है शान हमारी मेरे भारत की बेटी जीती रहो जीतती रहो जो तेरे नैनों से टपके हर आंसू है अपना जो तेरे होठों पे ठहरे वो गीत अब अपना जो सीना तान के तू चल दे उठता है सर अपना जा जी ले अपनी जिंदड़ी सर पर हाथ है अपना तेरा जो भी है सपना अब जिम्मा है अपना सपने सच करने की तेरी बारी
गीत गाओ के यार तू जगाओ अगर तुम कहो
Hello. Hello, sister. How are you feeling? Audience. Oh, yes, this is what I want. Sister, please sit. And Abhi, like you saw, our kids dance well. Unke saath saath hamare teachers ne dance kiya. Now, 1 minute, aap sab dance karenge for sister. I'll teach you very fast. Okay, all of you, baithe baithe bhi kar sakte. And remember, aap sab sister ke liye kar rahe hain. First step, all of you,
just do this for me. Very nice. Very good.
Second step, you're looking. Third step, that's it. Okay, uske baad, call
and namaste.
And you have to follow me. Is that clear?
Yes.
All students, parents and teacher, please play the track. Yes.
Haji thehro, zara dekho, kuch socho, zara samjho. Haji thehro, zara dekho, kuch socho, zara samjho.
The show is not over. Children, wherever you are, please be seated wherever you are. We now have the most solemn occasion for the day, and that is the felicitation of our dear headmistress, Sister Shiny Alphonse. So as we have gathered here, so today we have gathered here to bid farewell to our esteemed headmistress, Sister Shiny Alphonse, who has dedicated 8 incredible years to our school. As we stand on the brink of change, it is mixed emotions that we express our gratitude to a leader who has left an indelible mark in our institution. In Sister Shiny, we found not just a leader, but a mentor, a visionary, a companion, a friend. Sister Shiny has shown unwavering commitment to her betterment of our school, its students, and its staff. Under her guidance, our school has flourished academically, artistically, and ethically. Sister Shiny, you have been a beacon of inspiration, always encouraging us to strive for excellence. She has fostered an atmosphere where every student felt valued and heard. As we bid farewell today, we are not just saying goodbye to our headmistress, but to a legacy that will continue to shape the future of our school. We will really miss you and your leadership, but we also await and we are excited to see our new headmistress embark on a new journey, knowing that her passion and dedication will undoubtedly light up new horizons. We wish you, dear Sister Shiny, the success and happiness in all your future endeavors in Auxilium Lonavala. So let's raise our voices in unison to express our heartfelt thanks to our dear Sister Shiny for her unwavering dedication, leadership, and for being the driving force behind the transformation of our school. Farewell, sister. I now call upon our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, to do the honors of felicitating Sister Shiny.
शीश झुकावा मेरी दिल जाड़िया तेरे नाम जो कर जावा कम है दो तू सारे जहां से प्यार मेरे भारत की बेटी सारे जहां पे भारी मेरे भारत
Students, please go down. Students, please leave the stage. Students, please leave the stage. Go down. We'll call you all up. Please leave the stage.
Okay, good evening to all. Okay, if you really want, if you really love me, you'll keep quiet now. Students, you can sit wherever you are standing. Okay, it looks like I'm going tonight. Don't be so happy that I'll go tonight. I'm not going so fast. I will see that you write your exams well. I will, till then, I will be behind you, scolding you. Yes? If you say, I love you, don't think tomorrow I'll not scold you. Okay? Till I will go, I will be behind you to do well. Okay. So, respected chief guest, Father Joby Matthew, our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, distinguished guests, sisters, priests, parents, staff, well-wishers, and my dear, dear, dear students. Good evening to one and all. I stand before you today humbled and filled with gratitude. We celebrate the Diamond Jubilee annual day of our beloved school, and it also happened to be the culmination of my 8 years in Auxilium Bandra. I happened to come in the middle of the year. I came in the month of November, and I'm going also in the month of November. So it's a completed 8 years, and I'm getting a transfer to, as teacher said, to Auxilium Lonavala. Today I'm both humbled and touched by the warmth and affection that you, dear staff, management, students and parents and well-wishers have bestowed upon me. It is with a heart brimming with emotions that I express my deepest gratitude to the entire Auxilium family. Throughout these years, I have been fortunate to witness an incredible community come together. A community of teachers, parents, and students who believed in the transforming power of education. Your unwavering support has been my pillar of strength. It is your trust and confidence in me that has allowed us to dream big and accomplish even bigger. The trust that the management placed in me has been a source of inspiration. It has given me the confidence to lead with conviction, to innovate, and to strive for excellence. Their vision, wisdom, and commitment to the holistic development of our students have shaped the very essence of our school. The staff, the backbone of this institution, has been a source of constant encouragement and dedication. Their tireless efforts in nurturing young minds, in going above and beyond, have been nothing short of commendable. It's your collective passion for education that has set new benchmarks in every academic year. And to you, my dear students, you are the life of our school. We always say when students are not there, the school is fast asleep. It's midnight. And you bring lot of joy, love, smile and cheer to our school. And I don't have to tell you that I love you, should I? You know that I love you, and I don't want to say it again. You know it, and continue to know that I love you and I care for your good. Your trust in me, dear students, as your principal, has been a source of immense pride. Watching you grow, learn and evolve into responsible citizens fills me with boundless hope for the future. And to you, dear parents, your trust in our institution, your belief in our vision, and the tireless efforts you put forth in nurturing and guiding your children have not only made them excel academically, but also instilled in them the values and character traits that will serve them well throughout their lives. As I bid farewell to this our beloved institution, Auxilium Bandra, I carry with me cherished memories, invaluable lessons, and the knowledge that the Auxilium spirit will forever be a part of me. The friendships cherished, the lessons learned, and the collective achievements will forever hold a special place in my heart. I also remember with love and gratitude all our past pupils, even those whom I didn't live with, I didn't teach. They also come to the school with so much of love, as if I have been their mentor and guide. And we have Jharna here, who is a model for all the past pupils. All the past pupils, like Jharna, they are so committed to the school and its growth. I would like to say a special word of thanks to our manager, Sister Teresa Plathra, for her continuous support and today for this felicitation program. I went on saying, Sister, I don't want anything on the annual day. Let's have a farewell in the school after the exams. But it was Sister's insistence together with the staff which you witnessed now, the farewell program. Thanks to our wonderful staff for your affection and considering me a part of your family. You share with me your joys and your sorrows. Every teacher has a special place in my heart. And as I tell the children, you know that I love you, you know that I love you too. May God bless each one of you abundantly, parents, well-wishers, teachers and students. And may Auxilium Convent High School continue to be a beacon of light and hope for generations to come. Thank you and God bless you. I would like to say a special thanks to all our sisters from different communities. They have come here. And also our principals from different schools. And they have stayed with us for so long. Thank you, sisters. And thanks for making it today. I really appreciate your gesture of being with us till 9 o'clock. Thank you to our fathers who are there, the St. Paul fathers. They have been always with us in all our annual days, all our programs. Thank you, fathers. Thanks to one and all. I can never stop. I would like also to say a word of thanks to our volunteers today, especially the PTA members and also generous parents who came forward to help. And they have been standing throughout. So, thank you, parents. May God bless you.
Thank you, sister, for your words of encouragement. Thank you, one and all, for your cooperation. As we conclude this program, we will all stand and sing the national anthem. We will all stand in silence for the national anthem.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्तर बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उज्जल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दाय नायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता।